Hello, my name is Derek S. Hicks. I'm Associate Professor of Religion and Culture at Wake Forest University's School of Divinity and Director of the Center for Research, Engagement, and Collaboration in African American Life at Wake Forest University. My deep and brooding interest in African American religious life was significantly shaped by the book I want to talk about today. David Walker's appeal to the colored citizens of the world, but in particular and very expressly, to those of the United States of America. Yes, that is a long and rather specific title, but Mr. Walker's intent was sharply focused. This short book, written in the form of a preamble and four articles, which I'll say more about later, was completed in 1829 by David Walker, a free black man and owner of a used clothing shop in Boston, Massachusetts. Walker himself had made his way to Boston from Wilmington, North Carolina. Some scholars suggest that before he made his way north, Walker likely went south for a pivotal sojourn in Charleston, South Carolina. There he would have come of age when Denmark Vesey was leading plans for a large-scale slave insurrection. While Vesey and his co-conspirators were ultimately captured before the rebellion could be accomplished, Walker was able to migrate or escape to Boston, likely shaken but infused with new resolve. As revealed in the preamble to his appeal, Walker intended far-reaching impact of this work, which he smuggled south to plantations. He articulates the reasons for his writing this way. But against all accusations which may or can be preferred against me, I appeal to heaven for my motive in writing, who knows that my object is, if possible, to awaken in the breasts of my afflicted, degraded, and slumbering brethren a spirit of inquiry and investigation respecting our miseries and wretchedness in this Republican land of liberty, quote, end quote. David Walker's appeal is fascinating. It allows us to consider its merits in terms of both its content and construction. The merits of his content are readily apparent. The objective of the appeal was in part to instill pride and invigorate aggressive, sociopolitical, and religiously motivated contestation among its enslaved readers. It vehemently attacked the institution of slavery, revealing the moral problem that existed with America being at once a slaveholding nation while simultaneously professing Christian values and sensibilities. America, Walker believed, belonged to all who had helped to build it. But the more intriguing aspect of Walker's appeal is found in its construction. As I mentioned earlier, it's structured in the form of a preamble and four articles. It seems to me that David Walker meant for his appeal to be a counter-US constitutional document with the intent of reconstituting the soul of America. It unapologetically demanded that the United States adopt its own principles as established in the preambles to its Declaration of Independence and U.S. Constitution. As a counter-constitutional document, it intends to secure the freedoms of the afflicted by highlighting the truth about both their sufferings and their God-given humanity. This was a bold and dangerous task. However, it was a task that David Walker approached with the conviction of one who had witnessed firsthand the atrocities of slavery and was convinced of the hypocrisy of a so-called Christian nation holding so many people in abject bondage. Now, David Walker would be found dead in 1830 under suspicious circumstances, yet his appeal remained a rallying cry, giving language to the early freedom struggles of black people in this country. Its words would influence other freedom fighters like Maria Stewart and Frederick Douglass. Reaching beyond barriers of race, geography, and political affiliation or religious adherence, Walker sought to reconstitute America so that it stood for what it had put on paper. Thank you so much for watching. Please check back soon for another episode of Architects of Hope from Wake Forest University's School of Divinity.